How did I get involved in Garth? I was sent a copy of the novel, and it was inscribed, "Dear Brendan, thank you for inspiring the character of Mo in this story." I know, I did that kind of face, like, huh? Like someone winding me up here, and I hope one day you can read it aloud to your kids too. Yours truly, Cornelia Funke. And I thought, come on, you know, I thought someone was having me on. So I read the book, and it was really captivating. It is Meggie's story, the little girl who's played by Eliza Bennett. Eliza is easily one of the most important emerging talents in acting, in my experience, and we'll be hearing a lot more about her. You'll be hearing a lot more about. She was previously in Nanny McPhee. Wonderful girl, triple threat, good-looking kid, really well behaved. She can sing, and she's a wonderful actress. I think they just, I'd like to think they think I'm the ultimate hero on account of I'm just dad. And that's all I ever hope and aspire to. But sometimes it's, Dad, go get me a drink of water. Dad, what time is SpongeBob SquarePants on? Dad, can you buy me that? That's my kid. They're not like, oh, father. My movie star here. No. Just, Dad, I pooed in my pants. Come on. There's no difference. No, time out. I just like to get clearly get something straight here. The internet is not the last word. And I know you're laughing because I know where you're going with this, honey. I get your number. And I say this with affection, all the computer nerds and comic book geeks think that I am gung ho, but I'm not. I don't have a name for the character, and it's just a cameo, all right? Cause gung ho, and this is just a personal view, is attired and looks sort of like. Maybe one of the guys that didn't make it into the Village People. Just put it that way. So no, you won't be seeing me in a handlebar mustache with a flak jacket and a tattoo. I begged to be in the movie, to tell you the truth. I said, I'll walk your dog. I'll wash your car. I'll make you breakfast, please. Because I had a G.I. Joe, and my G.I. Joe wound up dangling from his parachute strings where I had thrown him from the roof to try and get a little bit more air and deploy the parachute. But he was there all winter just. And I took him down in the spring with a rake. Whack! He broke a few bones off and parts and his head went. And but I glued him back up and taped him, stuck him to a Tonka truck, packed him full of firecrackers and lit it. You
And that's
know?
your character then.
No, that's just me in my spare time. This is just like, last week.